Hi guys, welcome back to K-World for the 4th and 5th episodes recap of Squid Game. With the plot spoiler alert, let's get to the video. The episode starts as player 111 gets secretly guided away by a group of staff. On returning to the dormitory, Il-num thanks Gi-hun, since he has managed to get through the game because he copied his method. Sung-woo and Ollie run to greet them, and Sung-woo apologizes for suggesting to split up. But Gi-hun assures him he chose the umbrella and it's not Sung-woo's fault. The results of the game gets announced. Out of 187 players, 79 were eliminated. During the mealtime, Doksu and his team sneaks into the line more than once and gets extra food, so the last few players doesn't get to have the meal. One of the players confessed that she saw Doksu and team stealing the food, so the player who haven't got food picks up a fight with Doksu. Doksu beats him up to his death while the staff watch. Sung-woo and Gi-hun checks on the player, and Sung-woo notes the player is dead. Gi-hun shout out to the staff saying a player just died. Instead of responding to him, the piggyback appears and money gets accumulated to it. We then see Jun-ho switching his mask to the squared mask he collected earlier, which is a management mask. One of the staff notice him but goes silent on seeing the mask. Back in the dormitory, Sung-woo warns others not to fall asleep when the lights go out, pointing out that Doksu and others seems to be plotting a riot. Gi-hun notes the terrified Sae-byeok and tells her to join their team, since she and Doksu doesn't seem to be in good terms. But she rejects, saying she doesn't trust anyone. In a hideout, we see the player 111 harvesting organs from dead players to sell on the black market in return for information on upcoming games. Apparently, he's a disgraced doctor. After harvesting the organs, a workman gives him a boiled egg. He also tells him that a fight will break out tonight and to be alerted. The staff have intentionally given the players less food to provoke a fight to eliminate weaklings before the next game. The player goes to the bathroom and eats the egg. In it, he finds another note stuffed inside. He then goes to the dormitory and asks Doksu and team to let him join their team. When Doksu threatens to kill him when the lights go out, player 111 tells him that he knows what the next game is. When the lights go out, the front man observes the players through an infrared camera. Doksu starts off by killing the player who tattled him off. Jun-ho, now wearing the management mask, stands outside the locked door as the players scream out for help. Doksu goes after Sae-byeok, but she stabs him on the leg and manages to escape. She then runs to Gi-hun, and when Doksu storms at her, Gi-hun and team covers her from him. Il-num cries out, begging everyone to stop. The front man then gives the order to open up the doors for the staff to get in and to switch on the lights. Gi-hun's team then share each other's name to loosen up from a situation and to build trust among them. Il-num has a hard time remembering his name, so Gi-hun assures him that maybe because he was terrified by the incident. It appears 27 players have been killed from the riot. Doksu and team decides to go again after the next game, assuming once they kill all the players, they can walk out with the prize money. Mi-no seduce Doksu, and the two make out in the restroom. They share their names, and Doksu promises Mi-no to take her with him when he walks out from the games. Mi-no warns him never to betray her, or else she'll kill him. While Jun-ho takes notes when the lights go out, he hears the workman next to him coughing and calling out his code number. The next morning, the workmen cough again as they stand for the head count, so Jun-ho follows him. Gi-hun and team wakes up to find Il-num wide awake. He has stand watch as the others slept, fearing Doksu and team might attack again. The players get announced to follow the staff to the next game. They are taken into an empty space to form groups of 10 players. Sung-woo suggests to split up and look for men who'd want to join them. Since Doksu is aware of the game, he also gets his underlings to recruit men, and he leave out Mi-no. So she ends up joining Gi-hun's team. To Sung-woo's much disappointment, Sae-byeok recruits player 240, a girl close to her age. They are then taken to an area with two raised platforms, and the staff reveals the game is tug of war. Doksu's team gets to go first. Because his team consists of only strong men, they easily pulls the opposing team out from the platform, and a knife falls onto the rope to cut it off, and the players fall to their deaths. The next playing teams are Gi-hun's team and another all-men team. Following both Il-num's and Sung-woo's advice, Gi-hun's team manages to win. As the workman carries the players in their coffins, a workman draws a cross on some coffins before taking them away. The coffin then gets secretly moved to the hideout, in which organs are being harvested. Anticipating another attack from Doksu, Gi-hun and team build a barricade. Doksu walks to Gi-hun, teasing the barricade won't keep him safe. Gi-hun asks if he really trusts his teammates to be so confident, because if he were them, he'd find a way to kill Doksu first, because he's the strongest among them all. Unsettled by it, Doksu decides not to attack when the lights go out. Regardless, Gi-hun's team decides to spend the night taking turns on guard. Sung-woo and Ollie guards first. The two gets into a talk and Ollie tells Sung-woo that he has a wife and a child. When the staff were asked to get to their rooms, Jun-ho follows the workman who signaled him earlier and witness player 111 harvesting organs. He's shocked to hear the other staff members joke about one of the players trying to fight them as they harvest organs. After completing the harvest, Jun-ho and the other workman carries the organs to deliver. The player demands to know what the next game is, but the staff members are unaware of it. They break out into a fight, and the player manages to kill a workman and escape. The other workman chases after him and calms him down by taking off the mask. Just then the front man arrives and shoots the workman dead, after saying to him, "The most important rule in this place is equality." Player 111 also gets shot dead. Jun-ho and the other workman goes through a secret tunnel to get to a ship to make the delivery. The workman gets suspicious of Jun-ho's many questions and holds up a knife to his throat, but finds Jun-ho already holding his gun at him. He thinks the player they joked about is his brother, but the workman terrifyingly tells him the player is a woman. He tells Jun-ho that there is a list that includes personal information and medical record of all the players in the front man's room. And so he can find if his brother was among the players if he goes through that list. The workman offers to help Jun-ho, but he shoots him dead and manages to sneak into the front man's room. The front man and team manages to find all the dead workmen and realize one has ran off. He begins a facility-wide manhunt for the missing workman, who is Jun-ho. From the pile of documents in the front man's room, Jun-ho learns that the game has been running for over 30 years and that his brother Hwang In-ho was the winner in 2015. That's it for this video, guys. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoy it and I'll see you next time.